Research team discovers a 70-year-old hidden secret inside an abandoned apartment in Paris.
But before we start, please take a moment to give this video a like, subscribe to Happy World, and hit the bell so you'll never miss these great stories.
It all started ordinarily, but ended on the most unexpected note. An inexplicably quiet woman in her 90s died in 2010, leaving behind her house and lots of head-spinning mysteries. The old lady had kept lots of secrets from the world, and when her soul departed from her body, her secrets too scattered away like many pieces of paper. Her secrets began crawling out bit by bit, and all of them had the potential of surprising the world. One of them was that the woman had one more apartment in Paris that she never mentioned about her entire lifetime. What was so different about it? A team of experts was formed to evaluate the assets of that apartment, but when they opened the door of the long-hidden house, they felt as if they'd entered another world. The apartment was full of highly valuable items, but that wasn't what astounded the experts the most. Among all these items, there was one thing that made them jump out of their skin. Experts had never seen something like this. Mrs. DeFlorian, a frail old lady, said her final goodbye to the world in June 2010 in the countryside of southern France. The woman, when was alive, remained a mystery to her surrounding as she never talked much to people. The 91-year-old lady had very few friends, and just like her life, the death of the woman too fell into obscurity. But as they say, the quietest people have the loudest minds. Well, her death brought a lesser-known and surprising fact about her into the light. The woman had one more apartment in Paris, and unsurprisingly, not many people knew about this property of hers. The woman had never been heard mentioning her Paris-based apartment to anyone. She kept her apartment a secret for 70 years, and now as she was gone, her apartment's secret remained unguarded. A team of professionals was formed to check out the mysterious place. The team was going to evaluate all the assets in her apartment in Paris, as the woman had no one after her. However, the team had no idea they were going to discover something astounding during that process of regular evaluation. The apartment was far from ordinary, and this appraisal was going to strip many professionals off their sleep. What was extraordinary about this apartment? Well, see for yourself. Auctioneer Olivier Chapin-Janvry was chosen to lead the team. They had to visit her apartment and evaluate her belongings. What struck them first was that the apartment was situated in a very posh area that centered Paris City. The team was equipped with all the instruments needed to process the evaluation. They got another surprise when they unlocked the long closed door. It felt as they'd entered another world. Chapin-Janvry wondered if it was only him who was surprised by the possession of the apartment, or other members also had the same feeling. One could easily tell by looking at a single glance the apartment hadn't been used for years. Dust had made its home in it. There was a thick layer of dust on everything. Chapin-Janvry describes, "There was a smell of old dust. I stumbled into the castle of Sleeping Beauty, it felt like." The apartment was nothing short of a treasure, and among all the possessions there, there was one that stood apart. The experts couldn't believe it when they laid their eyes on the thing for the first time. The old woman had imprisoned time behind those closed doors. They kick-started the evaluation process. Every asset they evaluated was only adding to their bewilderment. The experts began to feel as if they'd entered another world through the gates of the apartment. Many of the possessions dated back to Paris's renowned cultural renaissance, the Belle Époque, or Beautiful Era. The experts evaluated many houses and apartments before, but none of them amazed them to this extent. Interestingly, it was just the beginning. The real twist was yet to come. The dust-filled apartment had come alive in the mind of the experts. The apartment was luxurious and beautiful. They imagined elite people mingling and parties thrown in the apartment. Every part of the building represented the elite lifestyle of the time. It had expensive perfumes decorated into dressing table. The place was furnished with luxuriant furniture and many fancy dresses in its closet that gave it a rich look. Surprisingly, most of the items concerning Mrs. DeFlorian hadn't been touched at all. The woman died in a countryside many miles away from this apartment that had been holding her most valuable items. Why did she do that? Why did she leave in the first place? The apartment and its late owner had whetted the curiosity of experts. The first question that popped in their mind was, who was she and how did she manage to get an apartment full of high-quality items? They needed to find out more about her life in order to solve the mystery. The documents they had about the old woman didn't reveal much. The woman's life had become subject of suspicion for the experts. They looked high and low in the house to find any clues relating to her, and then they found newspapers. Newspapers predated World War II, which brought a big portion of her life to light. The woman used to live in this apartment before the World War, and when the war reached its peak and the woman realized the place wasn't safe for her anymore, she abandoned it. She was in too much of a hurry to pick all her stuff up, and the woman headed to the south, leaving the city behind that had gotten attacked by the Germans. The government was dethroned, and the city was ruled by the Nazis. Amid all this, a 23-year-old girl was frantically looking for a safe space. Parisian hatred for the Nazis reached its peak. The Nazis would persecute them in the most traumatic way. The entire country was burning in the fire of war, and there was no city left out of the brutality of the Germans. In no time, the city faced a scarcity of food. Few people were imposed with rations and strict curfews, and worse, the Jews were picked and were taken to concentration camps. The woman, on the other hand, had found herself a safe haven, but her apartment kept waiting for her return. Perhaps the woman never returned, and that was the condition of the apartment. The house had been successfully guarded as a mystery for 7 decades, but now as the outside world set foot in the house, the mystery was soon going to be exposed. They were done with the living room, and now it was time to explore the other rooms. The two Rue La Bruyere-based apartment was much more to flaunt. The room they entered first was quite vast in size. One of the walls of the room had a bookshelf carved in it that stored highly prestigious books at the time. Not only that, the huge windows of the room were covered with gold curtains. The drapes were still keeping the sunlight out of the room. The team drew the drapes and the room got filled with sunlight for the first time after 7 decades. The light exposed each and every item of the room. It was as beautiful, as full of wonders as the living room. What caught the experts' attention the most was a piece of furniture, a dressing table. The table had hairbrushes, perfumes, and lots of candle stubs. Interestingly, they were all perfectly organized, ready to be used by an elite woman. The entire team had never felt so mesmerized before. They were inspecting the table when something strange reflected in the mirror. They turned back to see what it was and their jaws dropped. Where everything was up to the mark, no need to say that the dining room too was beautiful enough to steal their hearts. It was a beautifully designed room with a huge wooden table in the center, shadowed by a Victorian chandelier. The room's ceiling was tin-made that gave it a royal look, and the dining table had china pieces, house candelabras, and many more tiny pieces of jewelry. Clearly, if anyone wanted to buy the apartment, they'd have to splurge a big amount of money, especially after what experts found. Apart from this, they also discovered a wood stove along with a stone sink full of used pots, glassware, and pans. Whoever lived in this house must have been very fond of fancy accessories, big parties, and social gatherings. However, the socialite must have had one more face unknown to the world. That's what the other discoveries showed. The apartment had a number of taxidermies, and in those times, these taxidermy pieces were a symbol of royal status. One of the best of all the pieces was that of a stuffed ostrich draped with a shawl fixed before the floral wallpaper and wooden wall panels. It wasn't the only thing. The place had a couple of items from pop culture, i.e. stuffed Porky the Pig and Mickey Mouse, that came much before World War II. Many items couldn't survive the time, but then there was an item that was still intact and amazing enough to surprise them. Though every item in the room surprised everyone, this particular one took the biscuit. World War II is one of the biggest blots on the history of the world that took away many lives and changed the face of it. The war cost way more money, ammunition, and thousands of lives than any other war ever could. And among all the prominent figure of the war, there was one named William Hitler. You might have heard this name before. Adolf Hitler was William's uncle. Interestingly, William was recruited in the US Navy at the time of war. Post the war, the man changed his name. The National Socialist Party was popularly known as Nazis. We still address the party as Nazis, but did you know that the real abbreviation for the party was Nassos? Ironically, the word Nazi that has come from a Bavarian word translates for simple-minded. The US defense budget underwent a head-spinning expenditure from $1.9 billion in 1940 to $59.8 billion in 1945. In 1941, whereas a private was remunerated $21 a month in salary, in 1942 it went up to $50 a month. The war required men, and that's how the US Army's recruited personnel. Over 650,000 Jeeps were manufactured at the time of World War II. The US factories made about 89,000 tanks, 3 million machine guns, 7 million rifles, and 300,000 military aircraft. The already surprised Chopin-Genvry and his team felt floor swept under their feet when they saw something more special. Chopin-Genvry describes the moment his heart skipped a beat when a strange object caught his attention. They had to double take to actually believe it. Chopin-Genvry was rummaging through some of the objects when he saw a portrait of a woman. The painting featured a sophisticated lady, and by the woman's appearance, it seemed that she belonged to an aristocrat from the Belle Époque era. The woman must be from upper-class French courtesans, and she was dressed well. The painting had enchanted him so much he kept on staring for minutes. With that, a number of questions had popped up in his mind, like who was the woman featured in the painting and who painted it? Let's tell you a few things about this amazing painting that captured the heart of the expert. The painting was made by Giovanni Boldini, an eminent Italian artist of the 19th century. And the painting stayed hidden to this day. Had the experts not discovered it, the painting would have still been a secret. Well, as far as the woman in the painting is concerned, when it was said, the woman was Martha DeFlorian, the grandmother of Mrs. DeFlorian and also a socialite and theater artist. The woman was a renowned personality in the city in the latter half of the 1800s, as she was associated with a faction called Les Demi-Mondaines, the Wild Girls of the time. The group led a lavish lifestyle renowned for partying all the time and having flings with plenty of people coming from society high class. Very soon, the words about the painting and the woman in it spread around the world. The painting of utmost importance had been staying under the garb of secrecy for 70 years, and now as it was out had caused a ripple among historians and art lovers. Experts from every corner of the world headed towards Paris to know more about this painting. In their endeavoring, they resorted to French genealogical records to gather more details about the woman and her family. The experts found old newspaper clippings and birth records that revealed a great deal about Marthe. Her original name was Mathilde Louise Bourgiron. The woman was a seamstress by profession, and as she was already parenting two children when she entered the world of acting. So now what was bothering the experts was why the eminent painter Boldini painted her. Was there something between the two? Along with the documents, Chopin Genfrey also got his hand on a bundle of letters tied together with colorful ribbons. Well, the real twist came when he opened the letters. They had the handwritings of Boldini and Georges Clemenceau, who became the prime minister. As if it wasn't enough, the experts stumbled upon something even more amazing. Marco Tavi was one of the members of the team of experts seeing to the case. Whilst going through the bundle of letters, the man spotted a visiting card that was actually a love note by Boldini. Tavi explains, "We had the link and I was sure at that moment that the painting was indeed a very fine Boldini." The letter that Mark had found was a big evidence substantiating the link between Boldini and Marthe. And interestingly, that wasn't the end. Marthe DeFlorian was quite famous for her link-ups with prominent personalities like Pierre Waldeck Rousseau, the 68th Minister of France, Georges Clemenceau, the 72nd Prime Minister of France, Gaston Dumerge, the 13th President of France, and Paul Deschanel, the 11th President of France. The love letters validate the assumption that Boldini and Marthe did have something going on between them. However, the painting didn't confirm their affair, but the letters were enough to uncover their relationship and so the mystery of the apartment. As if the letter weren't enough, experts got their hands on one more thing that put all doubts to rest at once. The next thing experts found was a book. It was written by Emilia Cardona, wife of Boldini, in 1951. The book spanned her and her husband's life, and while writing it, she didn't forget to mention Marthe DeFlorian. Marthe was 24 years old when Boldini painted her picture in 1888. Not only that, but she also mentioned the two had an affair. Now her revelation only added to the confidence of experts. The researchers concluded that Marthe DeFlorian was a French courtesan. She was born on September 9, 1864 and passed away on August 29, 1939. The life of this woman had been erased from history all along, but now the woman was revived once again in history by Chopin Genfrey's team after 7 decades. The woman was born in the 18th arrondissement of Paris to Henrietta Louise Barra and Jean Bougiron. The woman had 3 siblings, but she lost 2 of her brothers when they were very young. Even the details of the woman's sisters were not documented properly. She became a mother for the first time on October 12, 1882. There was no detail regarding the father's name or birth certificate. However, the document did have his profession registered on it. The certificate suggested the man was an embroiderer by profession, and unfortunately, her son couldn't make it long and died only after turning 3 months old. And his death followed another twist. Fortune did knock on her door once again when she brought her second son to the world on April 7, 1884. The lady named her second son Henri Bougiron. Her son spent his entire life and took his last breath in the same city on May 12, 1966. He lived in the same apartment on Rue La Burière during his living years. Not much is known about his father, but it's assumed his father must be one of her lovers, including Auguste Albert Gaston Florian Mollard. It's also suspected the name de Florian might have been derived from there. Henri was with his mother when she gave up her soul in 1939, and experts concluded from his signature that he'd been found on her death certificate. Henri occupied the apartment with her daughter Solange Bourgiron after the demise of his mother. It's believed that his daughter is Mrs. DeFlorian. Solange continued to reside in the apartment until the World War started. It's popular belief that the lady was a playwright who was working under the pseudonym Solange Beldot. The apartment had another world in it. The house that came into the existence in the late 1800s and early 1900s and since then has evaded the touch of humans successfully. Post-World War, many things had changed. Paris was moving back towards development and the country managed to equip itself with advanced technologies and peace had been restored. The economy of the country was soaring by leaps and bounds, but amid the development, there was this apartment frozen in the past, waiting for the light to penetrate it. It was a time capsule for those people who'd gone much ahead but still wanted to know about their past. There was no doubt that this work of art was the creation of Giovanni Boldini. The painting was put on auction and the rate began at $331,000, but the price soared much higher after 10 bidders showed interest. At last, the painting was sold at $3.4 million. It's noteworthy that this is the only painting of Boldini that was sold at such a high amount. Ottavi puts it, "It was a magic moment. One could see that the buyer loved the painting. He paid the price of passion." Finding the painting in such a beautiful shape surprised the experts big time. At the time of war, Nazis were taking the best works of art and razing them to the ground. However, this painting wasn't only beautiful but a valuable asset remained off their radar all that time, thanks to Solange, who locked the door while heading south. You won't believe the havoc the Third Reich brought to Europe when World War II was in full swing. Adolf Hitler thought of himself to be an artist of first class, which is why the man got very angry when he was barred from entering the Vienna Academy of Fine Arts. Hitler took it as an insult and so ordered the Nazis to destroy each and every piece of art they laid their eyes on. And they also entrusted the fraction to demolish artwork that they only think is useless, i.e. modern art. His order was followed by the establishment of organizations with the aim of protecting the great artworks. The owners even offered to go into concentration camp in exchange for the protection of art from the Nazis. The Nazis nearly destroyed the world of arts. They plundered about 20% of Europe's art. Not only that, above 100,000 items never made it back to their original owners. There are no traces of many significant pieces of art, and then there's some artwork that's still unnamed. In this context, the sad case of Maria Altman would surely make sense. Maria Altman was one of the victims who fell prey to the Nazis' plundering and looting. The woman painting named Women in Gold was designed by Gustav Klimt, but unfortunately the painting was stolen by Nazis. Well, you must be wondering why the woman was so attached to it. Klimt called the painting Portrait of Adele Blockbauer I. Klimt gave it this name after the woman who was featured in the painting, so Maria Altman's Aunt Adele. The Nazis took away the painting after Ferdinand Blockbauer, Adele's husband, left the country. It was post-World War II, the painting finally reached the Austrian State Gallery. The woman clearly remembers the moment when the plundering took place. She recalled, "They just came and took things, they didn't ask you. They picked all the jewelry and paintings they could get their hands on and took them away." The Nazis also looted Adele's gold leaf 1907 portrait. She further stated, "They just rang the doorbell and I opened it and there they were. They weren't in uniform because it was Gestapo and they didn't wear uniforms. My father died 2 weeks after that. It was absolutely a broken heart. He died of a broken heart." The necklace the woman's wearing in the portrait was also stolen by the Nazis. Later on, it was gifted to the Luftwaffe commander Hermann Göring, who gave it to his wife Emmy. The woman bragged about the gift at different parties, and Altman described, "They immediately asked me for my jewelry, which I'd just gotten from my uncle for my wedding gift. It was Adele's beautiful diamond necklace with the earrings to match, and that one to Mrs. Göring," she added. Many years flew by, and finally the time came when the Nazi stolen art was being returned to its original owners. The news gave her hope and the courage to go to any extent to get her painting back. At the ripe age of 82, she fought the battle and won. The old woman managed to get a half a dozen of her paintings back, and the woman in gold happened to be one of them. In June 2006, Ronald Loder bought the painting from Altman. Ronald is the son of Estee Loder, and the painting was traded for a whopping $135 million. It was a record, as no painting had ever cost this much of money. Loder later brought the painting to Neue Galerie Museum in New York. The painting now is put on public display as wished by her aunt Adele, who died in 1925. This was one of the many stories attached to the painting. Though experts managed to find out a lot about Solange's life, one doubt still remained unsolved. This was a fact that Solange never returned to her apartment after settling in the countryside. How did she pay the rent if she never went back to the place? Did she know the painting that was in her apartment was of great value? If yes, why didn't she take it with her while going away? This amazing true story fascinated many people, and one among them was Michelle Gable, who went on to write a book on it in 2014 named A Paris Apartment.